So the reason that we care about biodiversity, first of all, biodiversity just means all the life around us, the plants, the insects, the birds, the microbes, the entirety of life that exists in a particular area, we say is the biodiversity of a particular area. And there are many values that biodiversity brings. And we tend to characterize those in terms of what they mean for humans, and we call those ecosystem services. So one of the values of biodiversity is that it basically supports all life on Earth. Without microbes recycling nutrients, ecosystems could not continue to exist, and we just wouldn't be able to, the Earth as we know it would not exist. There are important regulating services. Having a diversity of organisms in a habitat or in an ecosystem regulates that ecosystem in important ways. There are provisioning services, the things that we harvest from nature. So the food, the fuel, the fiber, these are provisioning services. And finally, there are cultural services that biodiversity provides. People appreciate a beautiful bird. People ascribe religious or spiritual values to certain types of landscapes. They harvest materials from those landscapes that may be culturally important to them. So the supporting, provisioning, regulating, and cultural services that biodiversity provides really have infinite value. Specifically in terms of bioenergy, we're interested in harvesting a certain portion of this biodiversity, the bioenergy crops, to create this energy stream for us. But we're interested in doing it in a way that supports all of these other types of ecosystem services. And I think there's real ways of doing that. So, you know, a specific example of the way that biodiversity in an agricultural landscape is critically important is two things that insects do, pollination and pest suppression. So without insects conducting pollination, we really would not have the food crops available. The food crops would not be pollinated, and those would not be available to us. It's estimated that 1/3 of the food we eat every day is insect pollinated. So it's a critical service. We really couldn't hardly live without it. And then pest regulation. Most insects don't become pests in agricultural systems. A few do, but most insect species just exist because they are being controlled by predators and parasites that that suppress their populations. And in fact, if we had to replace those services with things that humans do, those numbers might even be underestimates.